Hey, good day, folks. Welcome to another episode of Andrew's Life. On this video, we will be driving through the city of Columbia City, Indiana, which is located in Ridley County. It's about a half hour northwest of Fort Wayne. And the population is sitting at 9,390 people, with a population growth of 10.4% as of the 2020 census. And the median home price here is sitting at $236,000. However, there are several houses currently for sale, at least according to Realtor.com, for under $200,000. Now, FYI, sometimes a house might show as if it's for sale and the listing is active, but then when you call into your realtor, they might inform you that the house is currently under contract. So in this current housing market, at least in the state of Indiana, that is, you know, it's fairly common for something like that to occur. So FYI, don't get too, when you see a listing and you see that the house is available, don't get too excited until you call your local realtor to double check to make sure that the house is still available. But according to my research on Realtor.com, there's several houses in this city that's currently for sale for under $200,000. There's a house that's for sale for as low as $70,000, which will need a little bit of work and updating, but just thought I'd put that out there. And if you're looking just to rent, your median rent prices are going to go from $650 to $1,240 a month. And with all that good stuff, I mean, Columbia City, Indiana does have a relatively low crime rate. Both your violent and property crime rates are well below national average. And as far as it goes for the racial demographics here, I mean, it's not going to be the most diverse city here in Indiana. The racial demographics are going to be, I wrote it down somewhere. Give me one second here. It's going to be 92.5% white and 3.9% Hispanic. And every other race that lives in the city is going to be lower than 1%. So if you don't mind living somewhere where there's next to no diversity, this could be your city. I mean, it's only a half hour outside of Fort Wayne. And as you guys can see, Columbia City does have all of the basic amenities that most people would need. So the only reason why you may have to drive into Fort Wayne is for maybe entertainment and for work, depending on what line of work you do. Because depending on what line of work you do, you might even be able to get a job here in Columbia City. Now, for those of you that like to work out, I will say if you have a membership to Anytime Fitness, there's a very nice facility here. When I first began this video, I was in the shopping plaza where that gym is located. I forgot what that plaza was called. It's right by Walmart. So FYI, for those of you that want to start working out and taking care of your health. And as far as it goes for entertainment here in Columbia City, you have the Fun Center at Paig's Crossings. I mean, it's P-A-I-G-E apostrophe S Crossings, which is basically an indoor and outdoor amusement park. You got Chapman's Brewing Company, for those of you that like to drink a little bit and you want to sample some fresh alcoholic beverages. You also got the Eagle Glen Golf Course, the Whitley County Historical Museum as well. So those are a few things you can do here in town. Now, as far as what I think of Columbia City, I mean, I've had people tell me that Columbia City was, the people here in Columbia City were a little biased towards certain ethnicities. Now, clearly, I've never been here before other than to come and record this video and to work out at the gym. So, I don't know how true that information is. Now, I will say, when I was at the gym, I didn't have any issues from anyone. The people at the gym appeared to be respectful. And right now, that's really all I can go by. Now, housing prices here, in my opinion, are very reasonable. You're within a half hour of Fort Wayne, and this city, for the most part, is a relatively clean and well-kept city. Most people here tend to maintain their houses and maintain their yards. Now, this city does have a little bit of traffic. I mean, not too much, but it does have a little bit of traffic. And I would say for those, for those that don't want to live in Fort Wayne, but you don't want to be too far from Fort Wayne, and you're looking for a place that's a little cheaper than the suburbs, and at the same time will give you that small town feel, I would say Columbia City does a fairly good job of accommodating those needs. Honestly, I can't think of much more to say about this city. I don't want to sound like a broken record and start repeating myself. I mean, as you guys continue to watch the video, I think what you guys see will tell its own story. And I've already gave you guys all the basic information, so obviously if you have a question, you know, feel free to interact in the comment section. For those of you that are from Columbia City and you have something to say that I didn't put in on this video, again, feel free to put it in the comment section for everybody else to read. Because this video is for everybody that's looking to visit or move to these cities that I record. Alright folks, you guys know what you gotta do at this point. I appreciate every last one of you. On that note, until the next time, everyone have a blessed one. Peace.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.